So, I know you have a lot of ground to cover, Carlos, so I think this would be a good time to start with this session on the beautiful and versatile component set in Apache Royale Tour de Jewel. Having said that, I'm going to be quiet except reminding Carlos of when we get halfway done and almost done.
Okay, thank you, Andrew. I'm Carlos Rovira. I'm a PNC of the Apache Royale project, and I was the creator of the Jewel component set in Royale. So let's go and let's start with this component set. I will switch off my camera. I think.
We don't have a view of the presentation now.
Okay.
Go. There we go. Let's go.
I will use my marker to do some screening marking. And let's go. This is our journey. Okay, we'll see Jewel, components, layouts, and themes. Okay. So the first is to watch a bit about the total Jewel that is an application that I wrote at earlier stage of the Jewel development 3 years ago. That was it is growing through the years to show what the components can do. I think it's important this application because it allows us to develop the component and also try some of the functionalities, the bits, and other things involved. So it's a good playground to test all these kind of things. And also see that all continue to work because sometimes we must do some refactoring or some things. We used to recheck all the things that is involved in that refactor or the new functionality. So here are I first do some screenshots to show how is the actual look and feel, the actual state of art, because I think it's important to remark that this was evolving through the years, and of course, a few years ago, this was not looking at this is actual. You can see here the Jewel radio button screenshot, the tab bar. Of course, there is many more components in each page, and many functionality. Here you can see date field and the chooser or Jewel test input. As you can see as well, you are watching different themes applied to the Jewel, since we support different themes and different colors and different styles. So that will be covered through the interior, through this talk. For example, here we have a combo box page. And Jewel list, one with a red theme, the other one with the sunflower theme. Here we have forms and validation, and then card. Okay, the first thing I want to say here is why Royale? What's the important points to use Royale, because it's not only for people that are migrating from Flex. I think Flex is a good point to use Royale, but I think it could be a new technology for people that want to use to create a new application. And we have many great points that that you can think about it for use for choose Royale among other kind of application of frameworks. I think the main thing right now is React or Angular or Vue. But why Royale? Okay, was the main points I think is we are supported by Apache. So no big corporations are driving our decisions or for its own interests. That is very important because we saw many other technologies or frameworks and going down through the years due to some big corporation decisions. Okay, in this project, all depends of us, of the people that is working for the project. Then I think the best important thing is this is the for me at least is the best of Flex and the best of web development. So it involves around 20 years of web development knowledge. We have one important point. The next one is multi-target, because we have now JavaScript Flash compiling. So we have two targets, and in the future we can use we can implement, for example, WASM, WebAssembly, or for example, iOS or Android. And I think this is important because maybe people choosing right now a JavaScript framework could have some problem in the future. For example, if other technologies comes to be trendy, because his source code base could be begin obsolete. So in this case, Royale could implement a new target, and you can maintain your source code and just use the new target. Another point is we use source code as for programming, and then we compile and transpile applications. So the source code is not interpret in the browser. Okay. Then we have very powerful features that is not available in any other technology. For example, I think the most important is MXML, that is a declarative language, what we use along with ActionScript 3. And I think many other platforms try to create something similar. For example, where there is a JSX in React. But I think MXML is far powerful than the other kind of solutions. Another thing is AMF protocol, that I think is a very an amazing addition, is for in remote procedure calls, RPC calls, and incident have better performance than JSON. We have a remote object class that is used to interact with Java, with .NET, with PHP, with Python, and many other languages on the server side, on the backend. Then, for example, we have Crux and metadata for inversion of control or dependency injection. This was covered yesterday in the talk I did about the to-do MVC application sample. We have also data binding to update views from models in conjunction with MXML. We have modules to separate the application in pieces to run independently. And of course, I think one of the most important thing we have is the performance. That is amazing, and we compare with other current mainstream technologies. For example, you can see this graphic there. That compares the same component between Royale and React. Okay, I think the comparison is outstanding. Of course, we have object-oriented programming, strongly tipping, error checking, and also composition over inheritance, what we call pay-as-you-go and strands and bits that we already talked about it in other talks. So in Royale, we have some UE sets. We have basic, we have express, we have GUL, we have emulation for migration from Flex with MX or Spark. That was covered from Alina. But we are going to center in GUL here. So why GUL? Why to use GUL and not another UE set, okay? Okay, I think the most important thing is we want to use modern webs, modern browser web development. So modern components like a drawer, like a grid, like a car, because things are used to go mobile and we want responsiveness. So the screen size was adapted to a mobile, to a tablet, to a desktop, or a bigger screen, okay? So all these things in the Flex days was not here. So we have to implement in a new component set. This is GUL. Still customization. Another thing we have with other UE sets was that we didn't have any kind of styling. So I was with the problem that all things was looking black and white, or we don't have control over any other kind of styling. So I want to have themes. That was one of the main things we need to cover in GUL. Finally, we have around 144 different combinations of themes. Okay. Another important thing is that I want components adapt to different screens. I want to put the example of a date field. If you could use the date field in GUL, you could see that in desktop application, it will work in a way, but in a mobile, for example, it will show from the button of the screen in a more touchable way of work. So what was the GUL considerations? I was a big fan of Flex, but I think Flex was not the best in all things. But I wanted mostly 19% of the framework. So I want the best of Flex, but I want as well the best of the browsers or the modern web development. So for example, in Flex, I want to continue using MXML, AMF, remote object, but as well, for example, I was not very happy with CSX implementation in the Flash player. I think it's a big improvement not to depend on plugins like Flash player. So we want to grab the best of both worlds. I think pay as you go is another big improvement done by Alex Haroy. And I think this composition over inheritance way of programming with very few code lines of code in each file, I think each file or definition in Royale is around 100, 200, 300 lines of code. So the unit, the block unit are very tiny, but GUL is not using pay as you go in a way that is is always 100%. I want to keep in mind real world needs. I think it's very important too not only to use the concept itself, but to keep an eye on how people is going to use the functionality. Also, styling. I want to use not CSS, raw CSS, because I think it's what a bit cumbersome to work with it. But in the same way, we use JavaScript, JavaScript over JavaScript. I want to use another kind of language, in this case, SAS over CSS, because it was a compilation of the styles and many other things involved. But don't make it a need for the end users to use it. So it's optional. Our browser support, we start some years ago, so we want to support all the main browsers. But I think Microsoft Internet Explorer 11 was a big necessity, because many companies still are in that browser. Maybe this year this will change, because Microsoft is going to remove Internet Explorer finally, and probably it will be less important over the years. But I think it was a good decision to support from this browser for the to the rest. You can see all this information is in the in this link about below. So about basic and GWOL comparison, I think most important is that GWOL is on top of basic. Okay, so basic is the foundation, and GWOL is using basic underneath, but it evolved, it extend the what basic does. Basic is 100% pay as you go. GWOL is 19%, but not all. Okay. Also, the most basic representation of components, basic is the most basic representation of components, while GWOL is an advanced representation. So we have internal structures in the components will in GWOL to build good visuals. While in basic, the structure is the most basic, so keeping with the principle of pay as you go. So basic are usually having very raw visuals, black and white, no fonts or margin or colors involved. While in GWOL, we are using many visual tricks and tips to get the best. In basic, it was built as the foundation of Royale, so it is implementing JavaScript and Flash. But in GWOL, we are not considering Flash for now. Although I must to say that we have the infrastructure to use, and maybe in the future we could implement Flash or another target we could do. Then we are going to go over components that we put available in GWOL and are ready to use. Components are basically containers and components. Containers are created to hold an arbitrary set of other containers or components and can be populated via code or data. So one thing to understand here is that a container, for example, is a group or a container itself or any other component that can aggregate any other component. While sometimes a component people think that components that have some other components inside them are containers, but it is not. Okay. For example, if I have a custom component that has a text input and a button to make a search box, for example, that's not a container. That's a component because the sets of internal components used are not arbitrary. We know that we have a text input and a button always.
20 minutes to go.
Okay, thanks, Andrew. And components has concrete functionality. So we used to have containers to aggregate other containers or components with concrete functionality. We have right now over 60 more containers and components and growing. I think this is the very basic census of the components because I think we have many more. We have many subclasses and bits and things that make many other things. But I think it's a good measure of the components actual to see that we have already a good set of components to build almost any application you want to do at this time. You can see the full list of components here in this link, okay? Although we have containers and components as TLC or top level components, we have as well, of course, as we have, we are in Royale, we have bits can be common or specialized. Okay, we'll see in a moment what we are talking about. For containers, we have, as I told you, the ones that can be populated via code. And for example, we have a view or a responsive view. This is the main view of an application because in Royale, an application, the GUI application does not have the view couplet. We have the view is the couplet from the application. Then we have containers in the row sense of the term. For example, we have row or container. And this has as well another versions that are horizontal group, vertical group, horizontal container, vertical container, because these containers are very used in the application. In an application, we have as well, for example, card that is a container with with a sense of a look or a look and feel of a card. We have grid and grid cell for responsive applications, and then we have another container that could be switched on and off, or be visible or hide. And that's are this one here, section content, scrollable section content, or tab bar content if we use with a tab bar. We have four items that are very common in many applications. For example, a new component not present in Flex that is a drawer. This is a component for navigation, for main application navigation that used to come from the left or from the right. We have modules to create applications, modular applications that can be loaded separately, and many others like wizard, top application bar, footer bar, and many other ones. All these components are code-based, so you declare in the code, like this, and you add other components inside the tag. So this is creating a container with 12 div components. As you can see, you can mix GUI components with, for example, HTML components. That is, this is a normal div. Then we have another kind of containers that with a population based on data. The main component here is data container. if you remember Flex, we have a data group as well. Here, the main component is data container. From there, we have, for example, list that is very used if you want a selection or a selection of items inside the container, or you want keyboard management, tabulation, and many other things. There we have a tab bar, button bar, navigator that is mostly used in Dagger components. Also, we have a combo box, drawdown list that are very similar, but with different implementations and behaviors. Also, table or simple table that are to try to mimic the HTML table component, and data grid also that you already know from Flex. These components all used to be the common properties, the data provider. That is the way in which we provide the array of items to the component. We can we use in GUL array list that is different from Flex, because in Flex, if you remember, we used to have array collection. Here, the normal although this is configurable, we always use array list. And array list if we want sorting and filtering. Okay. Also, these components use an iter renderer infrastructure, because we want to be able to draw each item inside the list or the data container in a way where we can control the each part of the visualization. For example, if we want some data to have some inner controls, or we want labels or images or icons, we can use we can do it with an item renderer. This is an example of code from a data container. Here we are defining the item renderer, that is another MXML class done in another file, and configuring some bits like adding a scrolling viewport, adding a tile horizontal layout, and we are adding an array list of data, and we are using the array list directly in this component, because data provider here is the default property. So as you know, in Flex we have default property, that is the property that we can use directly inside the tag without having to specify that it's data provider. We call use here data provider around this array list, and that will be the same use. And here we are using some data object that provides to the array for a label, an icon, and that will the data used to fill each item renderer. In components, we have as well many components. Of course, the basic to create any application that needs text inputs, buttons, checkboxes, data fields, images, icons, numeric steppers, and so on. So, and also in each category, we have many variations, because for example, a button is the a button with text only, but if we want to use icons inside a button, we need icon button, or if we want selection toggle, we need a toggle button, and the same for text input, for example, with icon text input, or any other components in this set. If you know about basic use UI-base as the basic component, or as it will be the same as UI component in Flex, But here we have an style UI base in this as the main component or the main base component in GWAL, because this is the component that provides all stealing many other things that make stealing more easy in GWAL than in BASIC.
10 minutes to go.
Okay. Components are based on bits, of course, as it happens in other sets. We have a model, a view, a controller, a layout, and are configured by CSS. This is an example of a card with inside an EH1 HTML and two text input using a backward input. This will be, of course, for example, a panel for logging with a button. Okay. And here we have we want to cover a bit about bits, because we have common bits but that we can use all over all components. For example, disable could be used in buttons, in text inputs, in checkboxes, but also we have specialized bits that also can be used in a specific component. For example, is the case for text input and the text prompt, or the password input that can be only used in text-based controls. As I was saying before, all the components in GWAL and in BASIC also are defined through a composition of bits that are defined through CSS. In the case of GWAL, that was done in CSS. For example, this is a how list is composed through bits. We see it is composed with a bit view, that is list view, a controller that is list single selection most controller, or for example, we have the model is array selection selection model. Okay, so this is normal in all GWAL. Our layouts, we have to see, we have CSS layout bits, which I to delegate layout to browsers when possible. Basic layout is for absolute positioning, while we have another typical layouts like horizontal, vertical, and much more. This is, for example, a case of tiling horizontal layout that we are using as well CSS Flex and ES3 at the same time. We have also responsive layout that is done with grid and grid cell, and its layouts are grid layout and grid cell layout. And as you can, as I told you, responsive is very important in GWAL. We are always improving that in that way that sizes of the controls and the fonts and the text always feel the best as possible mobile devices, tablet, and desktop. If you want to use responsive view, you want to go to responsive, you must to use responsive view. Okay, and this is as well. We have many bits like responsive visibility, responsive seat size, and many others. This is how the tool that GWAL shows that it's responsive. As you can see, for example, the GWAL logo is changing the size as we go mobile, and also the drawer is hiding, and we are showing at this point the button to be able to get again the drawer. Then for themes, we have different themes. I will go quick here because we have maybe a few minutes.
Just 5 minutes now.
Yeah, GWAL theme is the master theme. It's all themes in GWAL is based here. And if you want to create a new theme, you must use this theme as a boilerplate to create your own. It is SAS and it has very some switches like light, dark, flat, no flat, and 12 colors variation. We also have a primary and secondary and emphasized colors, so you can combine these three colors using three themes, one for primary, the other for secondary, and the next for emphasized. This makes a total of 144. You can use SAS, but it's not a need. Of course, we have light themes all developed, but dark themes still are work in progress. This is a runtime switching, so you can switch runtime themes. You can switch between themes at runtime. And you can here is some GWAL links. Of course, the GWAL to the GWAL link. More examples about how to build with GWAL and the GWAL documentation. The future, continue improving the GWAL set, bug fixing. We want to develop new features. We want to develop new bits. Of course, complete the dark themes. And you can go from here. You, of course, you should, if you want to use GWAL, you should join our mailing list at that link, the user or development mailing list. And if you want to request a feature or get involved, of course you can do through this link. We have as well a Stack Overflow tag that is Apache Royale, so you can ask questions here. But also, I recommend to join our mailing list, and you can follow us in Twitter, in LinkedIn, and in Facebook. So thank you. This is all the talk, and we can go to the Q&A questions.
That was beautiful. You left three minutes for questions. That's great.
Yeah. 1 minute more than yesterday.
Chris was asking about skinning that used to be in Flex. We don't have the same concept here, but I think we use themes, as you pointed out. Is that right?
I use skinning a lot in Spark in Flex days, and I love the concept, but I found that in Royale, I was no longer in a need to use skinning.
Yeah,
I think we still have in MX emulation. I must say that I don't invest any time in see if we can do that in GWAL.
Yeah, Chris is saying he used to use it for state-dependent forms, so you could have a particular skin for a particular state.
But that used to be done with view states, I think. If we want different skins, it's because we can to change the visuals in a very in a very aggressive way that you can do changing only styles, only layouts because you have many more needs there.
Yeah, our time is almost at an end. I'm going to suggest if people have other questions, as Carlos said, a really good thing to do is jump onto our email groups, either users at royale.apache.org or develop or dev. And
just one thing, Chris, you are saying if you have enough frontend a date and you want to add a chooser, for that reason, I was doing date field in an adaptive way. So you have just to put a date field, and it should adapt in the right way in different screens. But I think I know that's not skinning, but it's a way to remove the necessity and always use skinning when you need really.
Yeah, Hugo asks, what's the difference between the user group and the dev group? The user group would be someone like I normally am. I'm not trying to build the Royale application. I'm just trying to use it. The dev group is mainly for people who are contributing to improving the Royale application. At least that's the distinction I have in my mind.
Yeah,
we have to stop. We have to stop at this point because our time is done, and Rich will come and kick me if I let us go on. Thank you, everybody, and we'll see you over at the Apache Royale site.
Thank you. Thank you all for watching.
Well done, Carlos.